Hello guys, now it is the fourth part that is known as purification or refining of the metals. There are various processes. Number one is liquation. Liquation is generally done for tin, bismuth, lead, mercury. Here we are considering the melting point. Impurities and metal both are mixed, whose melting point is decreased, that will first excrete it. That is first collect it, melt and come outside. In the same distillation, we are considering the boiling point, metal and impurities. It is the process to purify those metals which have the low boiling point, like as zinc, mercury, impure metal evaporated to obtain pure metal as a distillate. Electrolytic refining we have done in the 10th standard also. This is done for the low in the reactivity series. We are doing generally for copper. 1-2 time question has come. Copper can be separated by which method? Then your answer is electrolytic refining. Then main part is fourth, that is zone refining. Fifth is vapor phase refining. Vapor phase refining and sixth one is chromatography. Every year question is introduced from these three, chromatography. Now first come on the zone refining method. Yes students, now the zone refining method is actually done whenever metal is almost required in pure state, almost required in purest form. It can be done for semiconductors, gallium, germanium, etc., silicon. In this one, here it is taken in a jar, big container. This is the metal in molten state and impurities. Here metal plus impurities both are present and heater is rotating. Here, air again, whenever heater is rotating, then impurities will go on one end and metal will come in the molten state at one end. Then this one end will be cut and metal is collecting outside at the one end. So this is the zone refining method is done whenever metal is required almost in the pure state, and this is what the molten zone. The next method is that if we will discuss more, when metal is required in almost pure state, I told you metals like gallium, germanium, which are used as a semiconductors, are purified by this method. It is based upon the principle when an impure metal in the molten state is allowed to cool, only the metal crystallizes while the impurities remain in the molten state. Cooling, metal becomes crystallized and impurities going to the one end and separated. Next method is vapor phase refining method. Next student, this is the vapor phase refining method. It is based upon the volatility, means that metal can be volatile. So metal can be converted into the volatile form. Volatile means we will heat and it converted into the vapors and collected elsewhere. It is then decomposed to give the pure metal. That is, volatile compound is easily decomposable and recovery is easy. It is having two part. One is Van Urkel method and Another is Mohn's process. Mohn's process. Whenever reaction is there, you must write the reaction and get your answer. If it is demanding principle C students, the principle of vapor phase refining method has been asked, zone refining has been asked, and next coming chromatography has been asked. In this reaction, Mohn stands for M, and in the ABCD after M, the N will come. So it is done for the nickel. I told you to learn it easily. After M, the N will come. Nickel react with carbonyl compounds at 350, it will give you tetracarbonyl nickelate. It will be heated again and you will get nickel in the pure state with 4 carbonyls. Temperature is given approx here 330 to 350 and again here 450 to 470 Kelvin. Then come Van Urkel method. It is used for removing all the oxygen and nitrogen, present as impurity in the certain metals like zirconium and titanium. That's again after the V in the ABCD, Y will come, but you have to learn that Z also come. Van Urkel method stand for zirconium. And reaction is this one, ZR plus 2I2, it gives you ZRI4, and ZRI4 unstable gives you again by heating ZR plus 2I2. In this way, my dear student, vapor phase refining has been finished. Next is the chromatography method we are doing in this class, and in the next class we will do some metals. Yes, my dear student, the last is that chromatography. Its principle is that it is based upon the absorbing power of the adsorbent. Means of that better adsorbent will give the more adsorption, and it depend upon the absorbing power of the adsorbent. Different adsorbent has different adsorbing power, and it is done when impurities are present in very very minute quantities. In this portion we have in our syllabus, that is column chromatography. In this way you can represent, if we are having 3 adsorbent A, B, C, these are the 3 different solvent putting in test tube, making different columns, showing them differently. So a solution that is called eluent put from top side of the test tube, this is suppose A, this is B, and this is C. We will put the another solvent or solution, you can say that is known as eluent in the term of chromatography. If we put an solvent who is matching the property with A, then A will be separated. Then we putting another solvent, it might be matching with B, then B will be separated and C automatically itself will be separated. Next come in my class and we will do the isolation of iron by the blast furnace. That is one of the important part. Thank you, dear students.